स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 15. द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज वाटर. इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी दीज टॉपिक्स: अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ वाटर, यूजेस ऑफ वाटर, डिफरेंट स्टेट्स ऑफ वाटर एंड वाटर साइकिल. वी नो दैट वाटर इज अ प्रीशियस नेचुरल रिसोर्स. ऑल लिविंग बींग्स नीड वाटर for their survival and to carry out their vital life processes. The earth has 3/4 surface area is covered with water. Only 1/4 area has land masses. See in this picture on this globe, the blue color show the water area and the green area shows the land masses. Most of the water present on earth is stored in ocean and sea, which is saline in nature. See in this picture, 97% water is present in ocean and seas. It is saline in nature. Very small amount, 3% of water is present as a fresh water, as ice in the glaciers or water from the mountains. Now we will discuss the next topic, that is uses of water. In our daily activities, we need water one or the other way. So we categorize different uses of water as domestic, industrial and agriculture uses. First of one is domestic uses. Water is used in our home for drinking, bathing, cleaning floors, brushing teeth, cooking various foods, washing utensils, washing clothes, etc. Water is used to keep things cool also. We enjoy various recreational activities in water such as swimming and rafting. Next is industrial use. Water is used for generating electricity. We know that in the Bhakra Nangal Dam, water is used to produce the electricity. Water is used in industries for producing almost all things that we need. For example, paper, clothes, chemical, biscuits, medicine, bread, etc. Next one is agriculture uses. Water is used in agriculture for growing crops. We cannot grow crops without water. Water in river and seas help in dispersal of seeds of the many plants. Next one is different states of water. We see the different states of water at our home. When we freezes water, it changes into the solid form. See in this picture, solid example is ice, in the solid form in which the intermolecular force of attraction is very high, the intermolecular space is very less, so it is in solid form. See in the glass, the water at room temperature, it is in a liquid form. We store liquid in utensils only because the intermolecular force of attraction is less as compared to the solid. The intermolecular spaces are high as compared to the solid. So it can move. We can store it in the utensils only. In the third one, the gaseous state, in which when the water is heated, it changes into the water vapors. In this, the intermolecular force of attraction is least. The molecules of the water move in all direction in the gaseous form. Now, we see the some processes involved in the conversion of water from one state to the another. See in this picture, first one is evaporation. It involves the conversion from the liquid state to the gaseous state. See in this picture, when water is heated, it changes into the gaseous form. When these water vapors are cooled down, they will come back into the liquid form. This process is called the condensation. Condensation is a process which involves the conversion from the gaseous state to the liquid state. Next one is freezing. It involves the conversion from liquid state to the solid state. On seen this picture. When water is cooled down, it changes into the solid form on freezing. Next one is melting. It involves conversion from the solid state to the liquid state. See, when these ice cubes are kept at the room temperature, they will melt and change into the liquid form. Next one is sublimation. It involves conversion from the solid state to the directly to the gaseous state without changing into the liquid state. The ice is present on the ice on the mountain directly changes into the gaseous form. This process is called the sublimation. Topic is water cycle. It is the circulation of water from atmosphere to the earth and then back again to the atmosphere. It is a cyclic process. Different stages involved in the water cycle are evaporation, condensation, precipitation, and collection. See in this picture, when the water is heated up by the rays of the sun, the water evaporates from the rivers, lakes, and oceans to the sky. This process is called the evaporation. When these water vapors reach in the sky, they cool down, the air cool down because the air expands when it reaches into the sky. And these water vapors due to the cooling change back into the water. This process is called the condensation. And they form the clouds. These water droplets join together and they form the clouds. These droplets come back on the earth in the form of rain, hail, snow. This process is called the precipitation. The water falls on the earth in the form of rain or snow. That is absorbed by the, some of the water is absorbed by the soil and some water is flows into the river, ocean. This process is called the collection. This process is a cyclic process. See in this picture. Next, we will discuss individually every step. First one is evaporation. It is the process by which involves the conversion of liquid water into the water vapors on heating the liquid water. Evaporation takes place when the sun heats up the water in the rivers and ocean, lakes and turn it into the vapors or steam. These vapors escape into the air. See in this picture? As the sun rays fall on the earth surface also gets heated. This warms the air close to the earth surface. ये हवा जो earth के पास है उसको भी गर्म कर देंगी rays. This warm air become lighter. We know that the light air, warm air is lighter, so it moves upward. And cold air rushes inwards and occupies the space vacated by the hot air. This movement of the air is called the wind. Evaporation also takes place all the time from the water bodies like ocean, seas and river and also from the plants through transpiration. What is transpiration? It is the loss of water from the surface of the leaves through stomata. आपको मालूम है ना कि excess of water जो plants में है वो transpiration के method के through air में आ जाता है. And animal precipitation through जो animals को पसीना आता है वो भी air में vapors के form में चला जाता है. Next is condensation. When water vapors enter in the air and the air cools and water vapor changes back into the water droplets and forming the clouds. The clouds are formed due to the condensation. It is the process by which involves the conversion of water vapor present in the air into the liquid water by cooling the water vapor. How the clouds are formed? Clouds are formed due to the condensation. When the warm air rises, it expands and cools, because we know that when we go up on the mountains, the temperature is very low. So when the warm air go up, it expands and become cool. Cool air cannot hold as much water vapors in it as a warm air. वो वार्म एयर जितना वाटर अपने अंदर नहीं कलेक्ट कर सकती. सो सम ऑफ द वेपर कंडेंस ऑन टू द टाइनी डस्ट पार्टिकल्स फ्लोटिंग इन द एयर. वी नो दैट एयर हैज डस्ट पार्टिकल्स एंड फॉर्म अ टाइनी ड्रॉपलेट्स अराउंड द पार्टिकल्स अराउंड द डस्ट पार्टिकल. ये डस्ट पार्टिकल के आसपास टाइनी ड्रॉपलेट्स वाटर ड्रॉपलेट्स बना लेते हैं. व्हेन बिलियंस ऑफ सच ड्रॉपलेट्स ज्वाइन टूगेदर दे बिकम अ visible cloud. Next is precipitation. Precipitation occur when the clouds become saturated with water vapors. Water vapors ke saath wo saturated ho jate hain and heavy with water, the water falls back on the earth due to the gravity in the form of rain, hail or snow. The water came back on the earth in the form of due to the precipitation. Next one is collection. When water falls on the earth as a precipitation, some water seeps into the ground and that is called the groundwater. That is also used by the plants. Some of the water flows into the stream, rivers and oceans, and some flows to the seas and ocean, where the cycling of the water start all over again. With this, I hope you understand all these topics. Thank you.